Next door to our office in New Delhi, as is very usual in India, there is a slum. And the slum and the office are divided by a wall.
Sugata Mitra is a researcher for NIIT, a software and education company. He did an experiment to see how quickly slum children who had never touched a computer could become net savvy.
I made literally a hole in the wall, a rectangular hole, and I put a Pentium into it. And I connected that to a 2 megabit per second internet connection so that from the slum side of the wall, you could see the screen and you could see the touchpad. And I just turned it on and did nothing else. And I stood at a distance and watched what would happen.
Within minutes, the children discovered hyperlinks and started to surf the web.
In a week, they had learned how to drag and drop, cut, paste, rename files, browse the internet.
How many children have you come here?
In about 15 days' time, I got a very, well, pleasant surprise. There was a Word document on the desktop. And I said, but how is this possible? So I opened that, and inside that it said, I love India. And I said, but they don't have a keyboard. So how did they get that? So I called an 8-year-old called Rajinder, who is my expert. So Rajinder showed me how to do it. What he had done was he'd gone into Word, he'd pulled out a character map. Now, I didn't even know that something called a character map exists. I have a PhD. So he showed me how to get the character map out and then drag and drop the characters onto Word, blow up their sizes by changing the font, and then fill the colors into it so that you get these colorful characters.
Mitra calls his hole in the wall minimally invasive teaching. He only gives the kids small hints when they can't figure things out themselves.
They organize little workshops within themselves to teach each other what they consider cool things.
Games laga lete hain.
Games laga lete
ho. Jo samachar bhi laga lete hain.
Samachar laga lete ho.
Jo jitna item hai sab isme laga lete hain.
They have their own vocabulary to describe this experience. So for example, they call the cursor a sui. A sui means a needle in Hindi. And the hourglass symbol, when the computer is busy. Now the hourglass is not a common symbol in India.
Damru bolte hain.
The damaru is a drum, is a little drum. It's Shiva's drum. Shiva holds it in his hand, Shiva being one of our gods, and he plays the drum like that, okay?
Mitra says the experiment offers hope that India's 400 million children could become computer literate, mostly by teaching each other.
They found a student who knew something about computers. To me, that's the most interesting part of that example. They found the one person in the village who had some training, who apparently came and helped them. And I thought, that's what it's going to take. I think just putting in technology only gets you so far.
Copy kar diya? Copy. Test bhi nahi kiya?
Kar diya.
Toh wo kahan gaya? Toh dhoond ke nahi.
So now they knew. The other children who did not know had to learn from them. The division was not of haves and have-nots, but of knows and know-nots, if you like. But there is a very big difference. When you have haves and have-nots, you have wars, okay? But when you have knows and know-nots, fighting with the guy who knows doesn't help. You have to make friends with the guy who knows. Only then will he share that knowledge with you.